You know, I've always loved Halloween. For some reason, though, when it comes to trick-or-treating, most folks only focus on the treat. But even as a youngster, I preferred to focus my efforts on the tricking. Now, my earliest work was fairly basic. The older I got, the more sophisticated my pranking got. And eventually, I learned it's better to watch your pranks unfold from a safe distance. But last year, I officially became a master prankster. Self-titled, of course, since there's no official governing body. I am so good at this. Anyway, Halloween is definitely my favorite holiday. And I'm pretty sure it's Trina's least favorite holiday.
In this bench so that when your daddy sits on it, it'll fall apart and he'll fall on his butt.
That's mean.
No, sweetie, it's a prank, so it's not mean. It's funny.
Like what Dad did with the phone.
No, that was mean. Well, the only way that this is gonna be funny is if your daddy doesn't find out. So you have to promise to keep it a secret, okay?
I promise.
Okay, Mom.
Hey,
hey,
boys.
Hi. Hey, honey.
Hey. Huh.
What are you doing?
Oh, nothing. So, listen, I talked to Daddy, and he's gonna take the boys so we can get to the Blue Goose tonight. Have you settled on a costume?
As a matter of fact, I have. And this year, there's no way I am not winning that contest.
Rodney, why do you care so much about a stupid costume contest?
Trina, it's not a stupid contest. This year, the winner gets $25, gets to drink for free all night, and gets his picture placed over the bar for an entire year.
Your picture in a bar? Dare I dream?
Mm. Westbury won last year, and he's never let me forget it. Of course, everybody voted for him because he went as a bag of pork rinds, and who doesn't love pork rinds?
Hey. Hey.
Okay.
What do you guys think of this costume?
All right.
What the hell are you?
I'm Envy, get it? It's conceptual.
Charlie, it's the Blue Goose. Last year's winner was deep-fried chunks of pig skin.
Clever and delicious. Gotta hand it to Bear.
So listen, you're still coming over tonight to help me take the kids trick-or-treating, right?
I guess so, but now I gotta find another costume. Perhaps something in the white trash snack food area.
Yeah!
Yeah.
No secret.
You do?
Yeah, but Mom said for me not to tell you.
Tell me what?
That when you sit on the piano bench, it's gonna fall down, but it's not mean, it's funny.
So your mom's trying to prank me, huh? Well, ain't that cute? Bo, nobody likes a tattletale. Here's a dollar.
To hurry up before all the good candy's gone.
Oh, we gotta wait for Aunt Charlie. Bo, don't do that. That's for the trick-or-treaters. Besides, that's left over from last year.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this year's Blue Goose Bar and Grill Costume Contest, Rodney Hamilton.
Man, is it good to be out of that egg.
You look great. If they don't put your picture up in that bar, I'm gonna lose faith in the entire bar contest system.
Dad, you want trick-or-treating with us?
I wish I could, but it's your mom's turn this year.
Good, because only dorks wear tights.
I'm wearing tights?
I know. And you're a dork.
Don't listen to him, Bo. Guys who wear tights are cool, like me.
I want to change.
No. Nobody's changing. Okay, we got to get going here.
You guys have fun. I'm just going to be here passing out candy. Hey, I think it'd be funny if I just left the door open so that trick-or-treaters could see a big blue goose playing the piano.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Okay. Nah, on second thought, that's really dumb.
Okay, well, tell Charlie we'll be over on Poplar Street.
You guys have fun. And remember, if you see any monsters out there, they're not real. They're just people in costumes. Except for the vampires.
Have a good time.
Bye.
You big blue bitch. You stole my idea.
No, I didn't. You think the mine that brought you pork rinds would have to steal from you?
I'm still gonna win. And for your information, you got the girl costume.
Well, boy costume was pinching my giblets. Don't worry, Rodney, there's no shame in second place. But now there is shame in not having a beer for your friend.
You sure I'm out? Thought there was some in there.
What, are you questioning my ability to spot beer? I guess I'll have to go for a run.
You're gonna look kind of funny buying beer in a goose costume.
Well, the only thing funnier would be two geese buying beer.
To the Goosemobile!
Man, did you see all that vodka the Pope's buying?
No. I was too weirded out by that giant baby buying nudie magazines.
Hey, Rod, pull over. Pull over. Right there. Pull over. Hey, that's Gerald Bob's cruiser. I just saw him going to that porta potty. You want to mess with him a little bit?
I don't know, Bear. A good prank takes preparation and planning. You go pranking willy-nilly and you're just begging for trouble.
Rodney, an opportunity like this doesn't come around every day. Now, if we saw a situation like this and we did nothing, we wouldn't be the men that I know us to be.
Well, when you put it like that, it almost sounds unpatriotic not to do something. You sure he's in there?
Positive.
That was childish and immature.
I know. I enjoyed it, too. Man, that was great.
Man, we are the best. Don't you feel like there should be a bunch of other geese carrying us around on their shoulders?
Hey, seriously, though, don't you think we should go back and let Gerald Bob out?
Rodney, he's got a radio. He can get himself out.
I guess you're right.
Geese at the Blue Goose. Little obvious, don't you think?
Well, we didn't have any choice. At the costume shop, they were all out of whatever the hell you are. What are you supposed to be?
I'm Dante's Inferno.
Oh, yeah, I got that once drinking the water in Mexico.
Where's Trina?
She's over on Poplar Street. You're actually supposed to catch up.
Oh, you know, I would have been here sooner, but there was this stupid police barricade at this construction site.
Construction site? What was happening at the construction site?
Well, Darren Bundy was flagging traffic, and he told me that there was this idiot who got himself stuck in a porta potty, and when the guy tried to crawl out of the air vent, whole deal tipped over, rolled down a big hill.
Was anybody hurt?
Oh, I don't know. I couldn't really see much past all the ambulances. Toodles!
See, Mary? This is why I plan. This is why I carefully diagram things out on cocktail napkins.
Now, look, just relax. There's no reason to panic.
How do you know? What if they connect us to the construction site? Where's your beak?
Well, it's not a beak, it's a bill, and I can't say exactly where it's at.
You lost your beak?
It's a bill.
I don't care. Where is it, Barry?
I don't know. It must have fallen off somewhere.
Like where? Possibly the scene of the crime, Barry?
Possibly. Oh, it's Gerald Bob. Man, the guy takes a tumble and a crapper and comes back to work the rest of the day. Now that is dedication.
Gerald Bob. Hi, Barry.